hook this a second. Let's see what we got here. Did you see that on the camera, guys? A mouse just ran out of that hole. I'm going to watch the replay again. Yeah, that was definitely a mouse. I just just watched the replay. He'd come out of somewhere and he went straight out of that hole. Okay, the place looks relatively untouched. Everything's still here. Chair's still dry. See, these bottles of water have been up in here, and the mice have been chewing through the top to try and drink the water that's inside them. Look. Ferns growing in here. We got the fireplace. It's fine inside, but it is. Oh, so much water on it. It's freaking filthy. Thanks. Okay, right, set my bag down. I think the first job is full sweep, all of the floor and all the inside. Oh, right, so head back up to the firing range. I haven't been up here in a while. There is a stairwell here, but can't really see it, so I'm going to give this a quick sweep. For all the haven't seen this area before, this is the firing range and this is the valley den. We have loads of videos on our YouTube channel of the valley den, but this is the first time we've seen it in sort of deep spring. The rhododendrons have flowered, everything's looking really, really, really pretty. So I'm just doing a bit of what I suppose could be considered spring cleaning, just a bit of sweeping. We haven't been up here in a month, so there's all these stairs needed sweeping all the way up here. In the firing range. This is Charlie's little den over here. It's been a while since the boys have been up here as well. And they're still standing strong. He's got his little chair over there and a few bits and bobs. It's a huge wood pile here that we've got. The little metal roof. This place looks great. We set this up in the winter last year, so we haven't really seen it fully flourished as it is now. We've still got a few more months to go before it starts to look really, really, really good. So. Right, next new addition, the inside of the stove door. I've added this sort of heat proof material. I'm hoping that it's going to work and stay. There was a little bit of smoke coming out the front of the stove, so using this sort of stuff, I'm hoping that it's going to cover the gap. So there's a bit of a gap at the bottom for that air to get in, but I'm going to fire this thing up. I need to dry the top off anyway, and yeah, see if we can get any smoke coming out the front. Hopefully it shouldn't be. Probably means I should clean the inside out, but I'm not going to bother. Just going to light it up. Well, the stove seems to be working perfectly. No smoke coming out. She's cooking away. Most of that water at the top of the fire is evaporated already, but still a little bit more. I'm going to cook up the barbecue in a second. I'm going to turn my hand to that thing because I want to cook up a burger or two. Alrighty, it's barbie time. So the new axe I put together, I found this this blade the other week, and I designed this sort of handle. This handle I reused from a pair of old shears, and it wasn't quite wide enough, so I'm going to experiment. I've added like an extra notch, which comes in from the bottom. The tops are nice and solid, but I've had a couple throws of this thing, it's not too bad. I'm going to see if I can chop a log with it, eh? Looking good. 100% British beef. Hereford beef beef burgers. Final stage. Gotta be a bit of cheese. Man burger. Got the other fire going now. I've literally lit all three of my fireplaces in one go. Right, let's head back to site now. If you haven't seen the previous videos, there's like 7 or 8 of them. You can go back and see how the process started right from the beginning. So it's about nearly 6 months ago to what she is now. There's been a lot of change. The biggest change is obviously nature. It was flooded and boggy. And now, we've got a nice little bushcraft getaway. The boys and I just come out and hang out.